said that today is Sunday. Would you agree? Could you confirm that today is Sunday? How would you confirm that today is Sunday, huh? Okay, because we're all at church, that's one piece of evidence that proves that today is Sunday. What else? You could look on a calendar and it would say that today is Sunday. What else? Anyone else have an idea? What? Okay, because we remember that yesterday was Saturday. That's another way to confirm that today is Sunday. When you confirm things, you double check and you say that they're true, right? So these girls, Deanna and Ashley, when they have confirmation, when they confirm their faith, what they're doing is they're double checking. They're double checking about their baptism and saying, do I want to be a part of God's family? Yes, I do want to be a part of God's family. They're double checking and saying it's true. So that's what they're doing today. We're very proud of that step in their lives. We have some work to do because June is Food Pantry Month for Aldersgate. Right? And so we have a red wagon here, a grocery shopping cart, and an extra box there. There is so much food in this sanctuary because somebody cleaned out their mom's cabinets. So we have a lot of food to collect. What I'm going to ask you to do is, Daniel's going to play some music after I pray. I want you to collect the food and you'll take it right out the back. And you can count the food when you get to the nursery with Elena. Okay, Elena? Can you give us a total? All right. So the first thing we're going to do is pray for the people who are going to get the food. All right, everybody, eyes up here, fingers on nose, hands together. Let's pray. Lord God, thank you for confirmation. Thank you also for the generosity of this church to support the food pantry. And we pray that the people who receive it will be blessed, not just by getting food, but also by feeling loved and encouraged because of you. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
through the praise of children and infants, you have established a stronghold against your enemies, to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place, what is mankind that you are mindful of them, human beings that you care for them? You have made them a little lower than the angels, and crowned them with glory and honor. You made them rulers over the works of your hands. You put everything under their feet, all the flocks and herds and the animals of the wild, the birds in the sky and the fish in the sea, all that swim in the paths of the seas. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
And now please hear the scripture lesson from the letter written to Timothy.
This is from the first book of Timothy, chapter 4, verses 12 to 16. Don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. Until I come, devote yourself to the public reading of Scripture, to preaching and to teaching. Do not neglect your gift, which was given you through prophecy when the body of elders laid their hands on you. Be diligent in these matters, give yourself wholly to them, so that everyone may see your progress. Watch your life and doctrine closely. Persevere in them, because if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers. Send the name of the Lord.
Before we get to the message, this morning we have a time-honored tradition of, talking to your spouse through the microphone during worship service. No, we're singing, man. No, hold on. That's confusion. Let's have a moment of prayer. God, we thank you for the celebration time, the times that our hearts are full of joy because something good is happening. We know, God, so often life is not like that. And so we ask that you would just really help us to savor these moments when these two young women make a profession of faith. Help us to consider the scripture reading and its application into our lives. I pray in Jesus' name. All right. Dave, where's Dave? There you are. Okay. Sermon just for the two of you. Oh my. So I'm just going to be doing this the whole time. There was a moment, actually, in your very young life, when you were just a little kid, Dave, that was so significant and so important, it changed your parents' life forever. And you might think when you were a very little girl, okay, that must have been maybe my first word or something. I mean, what else do you have when you're really little that's so important? First word, first step, maybe a little older. Oh, potty training, that's a good one. Could be that. Could be going off to preschool, another big day for your parents' life, big day for you. But that's not the day that I'm talking about. When you were born, you first drank a bottle, right? Or you nursed one or the other? Right, you did that. And then after a little while, you got on the solid food and so your mom and dad mixed up really watery rice cereal the very first time you ever ate. And they got it on a spoon and put it, you in your high chair there with a bib, and it was like so cute. And you're just, and first, they probably took a picture. I can't remember if there's cell phone pictures when you were babies, probably not. And but took a picture like this, old school, they're like, oh, first solid food, and you put the food in your mouth and you spit it out a little bit because you didn't know what to do because it was solid. But then you learned how to eat it a little bit, and they went to like pureed carrots and peaches and things that they hoped that you would like, but things that were also good for you. And every day, 3-4 times a day, they would put you in that high chair, they would put that bib on, they would sit down in front of you. If it took too long, for goodness sakes, and you were hungry, you would pound on that tray, because you wanted your food now, right? And they would sit down and they would feed you food. And you were little, and so you would smack at that spoon with your hands and not chew it on the floor. You'd smear it on your face. It would be a mess and a disaster. Amen, parents.
Amen.
Yes? Okay.
Still took pictures.
Still took pictures, more pictures, that's right. But eventually you got a little bit better at that too. And then your parents said, okay, I think they may be ready for something a little bit more solid. So maybe they cut up a banana slice into quarters, because you have to be so careful with tiny babies. And they put it in your mouth, and you have little gums with no teeth. You're like, And you wait. First piece of really solid food. Your parents may be fed a Cheerio, something like that. And then, in all sort of optimism and hope, mom or dad put a little pile of food on the tray in front of you. And first you swipe that food and smack it into your mouth. But then one miraculous, amazing, life-changing day. You took your little chubby, cute little finger and you pinched that Cheerio and you put it in your mouth all by yourself. Mom and Dad's life just changed. Right there. Because their life went from a pounding, screaming baby I walk through now to here's some Cheerios, I'm gonna go do this for a second. Okay, which is a huge, you will get there and you will know what I'm saying about this. It was big for them, but it was even bigger for you because you got to a place in your life where you were able to say, I want that one, and pick it up and put it in your mouth. You're able to feed yourself. That is so much what confirmation is about. Spiritually, your parents have been choosing and selecting spiritual things for you so far. They found this church, they encourage you to go on a mission trip or teach Sunday school or sing in the praise. And your parents have been selecting, encouraging. They want you to have things that you like, hopefully things that are also good for you. They drove you to confirmation. They've done all these things for you. And you are at the place now where we are saying now you're an adult in the eyes of the church. As much as the rest of the world is saying, not quite yet, kiddos, you got 4 or 5 more years, right? But in the life of the church, spiritually, you are an adult. You can be in leadership in the church. You have a vote. You can serve on committees, which I know you're thrilled about. Oh, it's so fun. It's like we're nominations are coming right up, too. You can do all those things. But most importantly, what it means is that you now are the ones who's in charge of picking up that spiritual food and putting it in. You have that responsibility now. My Bible. There it is. Okay. Paul wrote a letter to Timothy. Timothy is a young man. Paul didn't know if he was going to see Timothy again. He wanted to encourage him. He's a new Christian. Very talented guy. A lot of natural gifts, a lot like both of you, who have good spiritual heritage coming from your family and also good spiritual gifts to use in the church. And he says, don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but you set an example. I want you to know that now you guys are leaders in the church. You may think of yourself as youth, but now entering the ranks of adults, you are leaders in the church, and people will look to you for an example. So be an example in speech, in life, love, faith, and purity. And then just quickly, 3 things he said. Do not neglect your gift. Be diligent and watch your life. Persevere, he says. That means you got to stay on it. You're going to be in charge of making your own food for sure once you move out of your house, which you're probably counting some years towards, right? 4 or 5 more years when you go to school. You're going to be feeding yourself. And if suddenly you start feeding yourself and you gain 25 pounds and your skin breaks out, you know you're not feeding yourself really well, right? And you're going to have to take a look at that and make some adjustments. Same thing spiritually. If you find yourself cynical, nasty, jaded, sarcastic, down on the world, hating everybody. If that's the spiritual attitude you have going on, in the same way, you should check yourself. What am I not doing? What do I need to adjust so that spiritually I can be more healthy? Because you now are the ones in charge of picking up that spiritual food and putting it in your mouth. You guys are going to do awesome. I'm so proud of you. I want to sing you a song, and then we're going to do the confirmation. Okay, Sammy, come on up. So we have this tradition, past few years, number of years, of rewriting a pop song for our confirmands with varying degrees of success. We usually try to ask them what song they like, whatever's popular, like out there in pop culture. And this is a throwback one, but I like it because at least I knew it. So, hey, Sam. these girls are really making a big step in their faith life. They're saying that they believe in Jesus.
They are, and they do.
And they do.
They do.
They heard that wonderful story, and I'm just thrilled that they're going to be part of our Christian family. Daniel, you want to cue us up? Important step for parents. because they have either had their child baptized as an infant or had a child baptized as a child old enough to confess their own faith. But they've stood nearby and watched their kids grow, and it's a significant day for them. So first I'd like to show a couple pictures of those baptisms. Ashley, I think, is first. You want to get some light? Somebody know? Can you get some light? We can see a little bit more. Ashley was baptized here. That's not how you spell her name, but that's cool. Never mind. Ashley. with her grandmother down there in the bottom left, passed away a couple years ago, and up top with Pastor Bryant. And Cheryl looking a whole lot like her sister. I think you look a lot like your sister. Yeah. And then Deanna was baptized when she was 10 years old. Well, there she is, just a few years ago. Because the passing team has waited until Deanna's old enough to confess her faith on her own. So there's those baptism pictures. But at this time, I'd like to invite parents forward to make statements to their daughters about what this day means from your perspective. So, although a day is totally about you, Ashley, Pastor Rachel is right. This is a rite of passage for the parents. In the last couple of years, I've seen amazing changes. I'm so proud of you. I remember when you started your confirmation classes, it took a little bit of by making you do it. You weren't sure you wanted to. You weren't sure of your faith. And just the other day you said to me, "Oh, I have no trouble talking about God." I thought that was the most amazing victory. To hear that was like angels singing and music all around in my head. It was amazing to hear that. It's so nice to see this journey and to be witnessing you on this journey. And it was your journey. And I'm so proud of you.
Hi, everybody. I'm Ashley's dad. Very proud of you, Ash. I love you. I didn't have anything prepared, sorry. I don't know if you can all see it on the outside. She's very headstrong. She knows what she wants. And she's going to get it one way or another. I'm sure she'll give it. Proud of you again. I love you. Keep going forward. You'll get what you want.
So I had to write mine down because surprisingly I was very emotional thinking about giving this little talk. So we came to the church when Dee was six. And over the years, we've watched her really strengthen in her faith. This church has become a second home for her. She feels so comfortable sharing her ideas and her gifts with everybody in the church. And when you watch the way she is with the youth group and the strong friendships she's made here, I know that these are, don't cry, I know that these are friendships she's going to take her whole life. No matter where she goes, she'll always have these people to lean on. Having her up there with me sing every Sunday is truly a blessing for me as a mother and as a singer to be able to look over and have her with me. Our voices sound so much alike that sometimes you can't tell who's singing because we just blend. And then this upcoming September, she's going to be starting as one of our Sunday school teachers. And I know that the gifts that she will bring to her class and to those kids will be memories that they will take with them for their whole lives. You are just such a breathtakingly beautiful girl. Not only on the outside, on the inside. And I know wherever your path takes you, I know that you will always have God to lean on in your faith, and we will always be here for you to help and guide you. But I'm just so proud of you and your dad, and I love you so much. So congratulations. Thank you.
parents, I'll ask you to just sit, if you want to just sit right in front of, pretty close up, because we're going to have to come back. So we have some words as a church that we're going to say together. Deanna and Ashley, why don't you come on up? We're going to say together, they're going to take the vows of faith, the two of them, and we'll reaffirm our articulation of faith, through the Apostles' Creed together. And then we're going to take a little bit of a pause, and you both are going to read your statements that you wrote for us. And so we'll have, we're doing alphabetical, so actually, you'll read your statement of faith, and then we'll do your confirmation, and then you'll read your statement of faith, and we'll do your confirmation. And parents, at that time, I invite you to then to come up and place your hands on your daughter's head during that time. So that's how this will go. I don't have my hymnal. Okay. There we go. Too many books and resources. Let's just put it all on the phone and have the phone permanently attached to our bodies. Oh, wait, we already did that. Okay. So these are the questions that were asked at your baptism. Actually, your parents answered for you. Deanna, you answered for yourself. And so we'll just be reaffirming. But on behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your own sin? Do you accept the freedom and power that God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior and put your whole trust in his grace, and promise to serve him as your Lord in union with the church, which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? And according to the grace given to you, we remain a faithful member of Christ's holy church and serve as Christ's representative in the world. Yeah. And do you, as Christ's body of the church, reaffirm both your commitment, your rejection of sin, and your commitment to Christ?
We do.
Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life and include Deanna and Ashley now before you in your care? With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround these persons with a community of love and forgiveness that they may grow in their trust of God and become faithful in their service to others. We will pray for them that they may be true disciples who walk in the way of their peaceful life. Let us join together confessing the Christian faith is contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again, ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit,
the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
All right. So, it's Miss Ashley's turn. So, do you just step off to the side, Ashley? Your statement.
I believe that God is good and God is everywhere. I believe that God appears in ways and situations that we may not appreciate at first glance, but when we look back, we can see all the good. We can see the good all around. To me, the church means a forever family and an endless community of friends and family. To me, confirmation means committing my faith to God for the rest of my life and try to be the best Christian that I can.
Ashley, may the Holy Spirit work within you that being born in the water of the Spirit, you may become a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Amen.
allowed to be known somebody since they were a baby.
I believe God is our Father, creator of our world, and he sent Jesus to save us. I believe God is with us at all times. He's with us in the most wonderful times to the most difficult times in our lives. Finally, I believe God loves everyone no matter what they do. He will always forgive you. I believe that church is a safe place to worship God. While I'm in church, I don't have to worry about being judged because of my religion. I can be and do whatever I feel comfortable with. It is also God's home, and I feel the presence of the Holy Spirit when I am here. I also love the fact that everyone is welcomed. Me being confirmed means that I'm officially an adult in the church. This means I have a say in what happens within our church. I can participate in more activities. Being confirmed is very important because I feel like I am a part of this amazing church.
Thank you. Lord God, when you shower us with this many gifts, how can we not praise you and try our best to return gifts to you? And so we ask that you would receive this offering as an expression of gratitude for all you do in our lives. We pray in Jesus' name.
In celebration of the 50th anniversary of the founding of Aldersgate, the Lawson Schofield Youth Scholarship was established to honor Ted and Marsha Lawson and Arthur and Lily Schofield, whose work as founding members of the church was committed to helping to transfer the Christian faith to the next generation. The scholarship is awarded annually to one outstanding youth member of Aldersgate and is intended to allow the opportunity to explore faith outside the physical church building with a Christian mission sending organization. And it's open to any student who has not yet graduated high school. So this year, I think we found an outstanding candidate. And before I announce his name, I just wanted to just take a couple minutes here, because there was to apply, there was an application plus two letters of recommendation that were required. On one of the letters of recommendation, I just wanted to just highlight a couple sentences that were said by this gentleman. In describing this year, it says, "It's that humbleness and selfless attitude that makes me very proud to have him as a student." And I think those are really excellent qualities to have, especially for youth that's looking to go and explore some Christian faith. And he closes in his recommendation, he has a heart after God that will make a great disciple for Christ with a mission to take the gospel into the world. And I think we all believe that. So without any further ado, I'd like to announce Weston Fisher. He's the award winner for this year's scholarship.
We won't embarrass you by making you come forward and make a speech, okay? Okay, some quick announcements. I need sign-ups for liturgists and greeters. Next week, I'm going out of town. I need those sign-ups today. I am not kidding. Don't pass those sheets without signing up. I'm going to be mad. And not going to be calling people tonight. Okay, that is a stern warning from your pastor. Sign up. I'm going to be going out of town this week. Pastor Rick Hughes from the Congregational Church is on call. The preacher next week will be Noah Spicer. So we're thrilled to have you. So make sure to be here to celebrate him. This afternoon at the Cicero Park is North Reading Town Day. Our church will be there melting in the heat. Please stop by. Right after church, there is a little celebration of Youth Group Junior, a little send-off, just a couple minutes with Bonnie Spicer. So those kids can go and do that. What's that? You're doing what you told me you were doing. That's okay. Okay. 2 minutes. Okay. Really brief. It's a big high five. Awesome. If you are a student in Sunday school this year, your artwork is on the kids' coffee hour table to take home. Today is the last day for that. It will be recycled, so make sure you stop by that table. If you will be in kids' Sunday school this summer, we're doing a Vacation Bible School. It has a whole soundtrack and songs and music. I have those CDs for you to take home and play in your car, and I will find you after church and hand those to you. And immediately following the service today, we are in a season of nominations for the new leadership year, which begins July 1st. I will have a nominations committee meeting. Committee is made up of anybody who wants to be on it. If you have ideas who should be a leadership, if you want to nominate Ashley or Deanna onto a committee, show up in my office after church, and we'll just very informal. We'll go through the list. I want to make sure anyone who has ideas about that can participate. The last announcement is that for the first 2 minutes after church today, will you please talk to someone you don't know? There are like 8 people in this room I don't know, and that's not very common. So I know there's people you don't know. Go ahead and talk to someone whose name you don't know, and then go talk to your friend. All right? Will you please stand for the benediction? And we will first hear celebration and thanks. We are thanking 2 outstanding workers in this church. This church runs on volunteers. Kevin Spicer was here from 5 a.m. to noon yesterday morning and was back here this morning from 6 to 10 a.m. Setting up the booth for Ipswich River Park. We appreciate Kevin. In a similar vein, George Dow worked the entire breakfast yesterday morning and returned yesterday afternoon to make cotton candy for another 2 hours for our booth. So we have some very hard workers, George and Kevin. May the God of grace and peace, the God who has gifted us our faith, that faith which we confirm when we are together, be with us until we meet again. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.